Hi there. This video comes with some exercise files and a cheat sheet for Photoshop. There'll be a link in the description for those. Okay, it's part of my larger course, which you can go and check out. There'll be a link there as well. All right, enjoy the video. Hey there, in this video, we're gonna look at some of the really tough stuff to mask, like this kind of out of focus here. Also this white t-shirt, because it's against a white background, we're gonna mask it out, stick it against this brick, all using Photoshop's new select and mask technique. I love it, it's easy, and I'm gonna show you how to do that now in Photoshop. All right, first up, let's go to File, let's go to Open, and let's go to Select and Mask 1 and 2. Okay, so we're gonna copy out the model, mask her, and put her onto this background here. Now, in terms of this image, I try to find a tough one. It has two things bad, one thing good. One thing good is it's a professional photograph, so everything's in relative focus. If you're shooting your own stuff and it's kind of out of focus, and it can be really tough. Now, the cons for this one are the hair. Okay, it's not a con, but I guess that's what we're here for, right? How some tough stuff. The other tough thing is when the shirt here matches the background. Okay, it's quite hard to mask, so I'm gonna show you tricks to get around both of these. I was tempted to find an example that was absolutely easy and perfect, but that'll just make you feel bad when you're doing yours and it's not quite working. So this is gonna get us like, 85, 90% awesome. It's not absolutely perfect, because just hair is tricky, especially when it's not quite in focus like here, and when the model's t-shirt matches the background is a little bit tough as well. But it's real world, people. Let's do some real world stuff. So this thing is called Select and Mask. If you're using our earlier version of Photoshop, maybe 2017 or before, it's not gonna be around, which isn't cool, but if you're like me with Photoshop 2018 or 19, it's gonna work great. So how this works is you need to start with a selection. So the way this thing works is you need to start with a selection. We're gonna start with our quick select. Okay, so you need to start with a selection, a reasonably good one, and then the Select and Mask is gonna do the kind of final touch-ups. So I've got my quick selection tool selected. I've got a brush, it's about 300, and I'm gonna start painting her in, okay, really broadly to start with, and we'll fix it up as we go. So I'm letting go. I've got auto enhance on. It slows your machine down a little bit, but it does make your selection a little better. And especially when we're getting to this hair stage and this, when it's really hard and not a clear background, foreground definition, I figured let's turn it on. Okay, so there's the big chunks in. Now I'm gonna zoom in a bit and just kind of work our way around the edge to make sure I've got everything in there. So, where to start over here? Let's leave that to Select and Mask. The wispy stuff, let's leave. But the stuff that's absolutely 100% here, not mixing with the background, it should be easy enough to grab. Okay, well, at least make sure it's in your selection. A little bit there. I have to remove a little bit there. Remove a little bit there. The auto enhance is making this a little slow. Okay, so what I might do is just show you the basics. Click to add, hold down the Option key on my Mac or Alt key on a PC just to tap and remove, and I'll get the editor to speed this up. All right, you're back. I was probably at that another, 90 seconds, 2 minutes, just to kind of get the basics in. Okay, so once you've got a selection, then you add a layer mask like we did before. So just click on the layer mask button. You can see it's okay around places and bad in others. So I'm gonna zoom out. Now here's the magic. It's this thing here called Select and Mask. You just gotta make sure your mask is selected, not the actual image, the mask. Click on it here or up here in your app bar. Okay, either one, give it a click. And we get into this view. Now yours by default is probably set to onion skin. I'm not sure when I'd ever use that. What I use is one of two. It's either against black and I have the 100%, I have the opacity 100%. It gives me a really good contrast. So my great selection, it looked okay in the last view, it looks terrible against black. And I guess that's just a good way of looking at it, right? Now if it was a dark object or dark image, I could go against white and that would give me a better contrast. But against black is gonna work for me. Now yours might be all tucked up like this. Now over here are kind of like global changes. It changes it to all the edges, all the same. And over here are kind of more individual changes. So in this case, if it was if it was just a t-shirt, like it was a product shot, I could probably just do it with playing around with these global changes. But because there's so many different things happening, like here and this is light, but then the skin's got good contrast, I find I gotta go jump straight to these tools over here. Let me quickly run through these. I never use edge detection. It kind of goes around the whole thing and tries to fix it all. I haven't found that good in my experience. You might love it. Under global refinements, there's two that I end up using, okay, smooth and shift edge. Watch this. I'm gonna crank up smoothing. It takes a little while because it's quite a large image, okay? And it's just gonna kind of try and smooth these edges. And that's really good when it's a single object, like if it was just this t-shirt, that would be it. Kind of smooth around the edges, makes everything look nice. This key here is quite handy. Can you see it says show original, or just tap the P key on your keyboard? See, before. You gotta give it a sec, it's stressing out a little bit, it's a big image. After. Wait for it. Ooh. Okay, editor will zoom in real close. Ready? I'm gonna turn it off. Wait. Now, there it is. And turn it back on, and that's our smoothing. So that's really good for a really large object. I'm gonna turn it completely off for the moment because it's too generic. It's working on all the edges, and I wanna just work on them individually. Shift edge is the other one that I use, and it just tucks out. Let's show you the opposite. Let's go out, shifting it out. Just kind of expands the selection, a tiny few fractions of a pixel. And then if I tuck it in, it kind of goes in a little bit. So in, out. I find that's quite handy if there's kind of color bleeding around the outside. I'm gonna leave it at zero for the moment, and I'm gonna work on this bit individually. So the magic trick really is this brush here, the second one down. This is going to, it's called the Refine Edge Brush Tool, like it says there. Okay, and it's really good for here. So how big a brush should you have? You're gonna have to experiment. It really depends on the kind of overlap you want. So for me, this size brush, okay, it's 200 pixels. And watch this, ready for the magic? Pretty cool, huh? Okay, so it's gone through and looked and kind of played with the contrast. Now, just so you know, this is not gonna be, like I said at the beginning, it's not gonna give you 100% perfect everything, okay, but it's definitely the best option there for selecting here. You can see it gets a little bit foggy around here. So I'm gonna undo and maybe go to a smaller brush and just kind of paint in little parts. And I'm gonna zoom in a little bit. Don't zoom in too much because it gets a bit messy in here. And there's a bit of hair over here. There it is there, okay. Now, the further you go around, right, it's quite wispy around here, so I'm happy to use a bigger brush. The further I go around where there's not much here, I'm gonna use a smaller brush, okay, and just straddle the mask and the image, just kind of run it along the center there, and it just gives you a nice kind of blend across the two. You can see there, some amazing stuff, and there's some horrible stuff. So far, pretty amazing. I love it. Okay, so I'm just working my way around the edge in little pieces, only because often I have to go and undo it because I might have grabbed something I didn't want to, or it's just gone a bit yucky. What ends up happening is if you use a too big a brush, you end up like in here, it ends up getting kind of ghosty in here. Okay, so I'm gonna undo a couple of times, edit, step backwards. Back to my brush. Now where you have to be a bit more precise is where you go from like this kind of wispy hair stuff to a nice solid edge, because if you don't, you can watch this, goes a bit manky in there. So where we get to this part, we're gonna use a different trick. So if I got all the hair now, good enough. Okay, so where it gets to this white edge here, this is the other tough bit. So using this tool here, it's not gonna work. We have to be a bit more brute force about it, because if I just paint it in, the background's too close to the color of the t-shirt. If this t-shirt was bright blue, it would work perfect. You could just run the brush along the edges, maybe make a smaller brush, and it would work fine. But again, I wanted to pick an exercise that was quite tough so that you've got the tools you need. So we're gonna use this tool here, and it's nothing fancy, it's just a big kind of like blob brush. And you can either add to the selection or remove from it. So I'm going to add to it, I'm gonna zoom in, and basically we're just gonna try and tidy up this edge by painting it in, okay? It's not very sexy. What I might do as well, where the brush is concerned, can you see my brush is quite, it's got a really strong edge here. What I want to drop it down is I find it's gonna depend on your image, but between 80 and 90 is kind of, I find, gives you a nice crisp edge, but with enough fuzziness to match the focus of the camera. Okay, because it's never gonna be 100%. So I'm just gonna kind of work my way along here. Just tidying in things. Okay, this is the painful bit. If this, like I said, if this was a colored, a really nice strong contrast, a black t-shirt would be perfect. We wouldn't have to do any of this, but here we are. So this bit that's poking out, same like we did with the quick selection tool to remove from this mask, we hold down the Alt key on a PC or the Option key on a Mac and just kind of just clicking a few times. So how much do I want to go around and do this? I don't want to do it at all, but what you've got to remember is I've spent like hours working on masks only to find out that like where it's going to end up is quite a mottled background. So you're not going to see any of this. Like, you know, it's kind of in and out a little bit because of my quick selection tool. But to be honest, I know the final result, it's going to look fine because the background is quite forgiving, let's say. So now we're back onto some high contrast. So let's go back to that lovely tool here. Okay, and watch this. Ready, steady. Cool, huh? So I'm gonna tap my P key before, after. So with this strong contrast, super easy. Just run along the edge and it magics it up. The smaller the paintbrush, the more you zoomed in, the better. I'm holding the space bar, clicking, holding, and dragging with my mouse. Okay, so now I'm just gonna make my brush a little smaller and just click, hold. It goes fuzzy while it's doing this. It's a little bit tough to know where you're going. And you can see there, it's not as great. This is because it's quite white against this edge. Where it's got a really easy contrast, it does a whole lot better. Okay, you can see it's there. So if she's had really pale skin, it's gonna be super tough and you have to get in with a really small paintbrush. Okay, and see if you can fix it up. Don't worry if you don't. If it's just a little tiny edge like this, I'm gonna show you a last little trick we're gonna use to kind of fix it up for the final one. Now, I should work around this edge. I'm not going to because I know it's gonna look good. Because remember, unless it's going against black, which is a terrible idea because it really shows the mask, this is looking pretty good. So the last magic you can do is this one here. So I'm gonna twirl up global refinements and go to output settings. Let's click on decontaminate colors. Ready, steady, be amazed. Cool, huh? Okay, it looks for like the color creeping around the outside. So you know how if I put something in front of like a bright green backdrop, that green kind of leaks around the edges. This helps to remove that. There's only one drawback with it and I'll show you what it is. And it's worth living with, but it's kind of weird. So I figured I'd show you it. You can see it's gonna output to its own layer with a layer mask. That's great for me. Click OK. And what it's done is, can you see its own layer and its own layer mask? There's the original. Okay, and there's the new one. Okay, so you've got this one always because this one here that it made, because we turn decontaminate colors on, it does this. I'm gonna right click the mask and say disable, go away for a second. You see what it did to the edges there? It's really weird, kind of put them into a super high contrast. For whatever reason, it needs to do that to get rid of that kind of color cast creeping around the outside. I'm not worried about it, just need to know that that's happened. Don't worry though, because on this original layer, he's still fine. If you decide not to use that decontaminate colors, it looks perfect. It doesn't do that weird stuff. So I'm going to enable my mask. I've got this layer selected. I'm gonna grab my move tool, click, hold, drag, drag, drag to O2. Drag, drag, drag. It's a bit big. Let's scale it down. Remember that's Command T on a Mac, Control T on a PC. How low do I want it to be? Just getting it to fit in. Hit return. And it's pretty cool, huh? I'm gonna zoom in. Okay, and it's just done a really nice job of the hair. The bit where I bothered to touch up the t-shirt's looking better. And that bit there, I do have problems with now. Okay, so you can go back, select on this, and click go back in and do select the mask again. Okay, and just use the paintbrush to tidy up those sleeves there. I'm gonna click OK. I'm not gonna click OK because it's giving me a duplicate. So I'm gonna undo because I didn't do anything. You're back on, buddy. All right, a couple of last things you might do to just kind of get these things to work a little nicer is I often find a drop shadow to the actual subject can often help it, settle in the image. Okay, so with layers, I'm gonna give it a name. I'm gonna call this one model. Okay, with it selected, we're gonna go to effects and go to drop shadow. Now mine's remembered what I was doing when I was experimenting with this. So what I done is instead of having like say, let's have a look, I'm gonna crank it up. Instead of a drop shadow kind of cast from an angle, let's say that angle there, what I'm gonna do is have no distance and have the size right up. You can see it just puts a kind of like a halo effect around it. And I probably won't have the opacity so high. And down even a little bit more. And it's just a, watch this, preview on, preview off, just helps it settle in there a little bit more. You might not like that. you don't have to do it. Let's click OK. One last thing you might do is the levels. Okay, so this image here is, it feels like this one here is quite rich and quite dark, the midtones are quite dark, whereas this one, the midtones are quite bright. So to kind of get them to match a little bit, we need to either play with the levels on the background or the model. It really depends on what look you're looking for. I'm gonna do it for the model. So with the model selected, I'm gonna go to adjustments and I'm gonna go to levels. We're getting pretty complicated here, I know, but I really wanted to give you the full thing of how to do it. So in properties here, I'm gonna make sure it's only affecting the layer underneath. So remember that little thing there says just affect the layer underneath. You can see the little arrow there says levels only affecting the model layer. And I'm gonna grab the midtones and just kind of darken them down a little bit. You can mess around with the highlights and the shadows to kind of get it to match your version, okay? Or at least the images that you're working with. And I feel like we're there. In retrospect, I probably would have painted over this more than once. Okay, you can see it's still leaking some of the light through. I would have probably painted it in a couple of times to get it to be a little bit crisper. It probably would have let a little less of the fluffy hair through, but probably what I would have done. All right, friends, so the basic rules are, if you're writing them down, it is make a basic selection using the quick selection tool. With your mask selected, use this, select and mask, which should be called super awesomeness. And then unless it's a really kind of even selection or a kind of even edge shape, instead of using this global stuff on the right, start working around the long way with the paintbrush, but it's not actually that long because it's pretty amazing. Let's hit cancel and I will see you in the next video. Hi, it's me again. If you enjoyed the video, a thumbs up really helps me and what I'm doing. Also consider subscribing to my YouTube channel because I release a video like this every week. Also know that this is part of my larger course. Okay, so this is like a free part of it. There's a larger course called Photoshop Essentials. So you could go check that out. There's a link in the description for that full course. Also know that there's exercise files. Those are free to download. Go check that out, link in the description. Another link in the description will be the cheat sheet. So I make it like a PDF cheat sheet for Photoshop with all the tips and tricks you can print off and stick next to your computer and be more awesome. Link in the description. Yeah, all right, that's enough. Hi, Dada.